Mary Ketteman. I'm Sergeant First Class John Ketteman's wife.
Hi, my name is John Ketteman, retired Sergeant First Class, United States Army.
My name is Nicholas McClintock, and I am the son of former Sergeant First Class John Ketteman.
My first initial thought whenever he joined the military, when he first did it, was that he was joking. I didn't take it too seriously. And then we had talked about it prior to when we first got married. And then next thing I know, there's a little short recruiter standing at the front door saying, "I'm here for your husband."
Basic training for me was very difficult. I missed my family. I had a wife and two small boys. I missed being away from home. I had a bit of a bad attitude, so basic training initially wasn't very easy. Once I figured out that I had to change my mentality and thinking and conform with the values of the Army, I enjoyed basic training very much. I learned a lot of basic skills that made me successful as a soldier.
It was like when John was deployed, it wasn't easy. It was very hard. It was, especially because the boys were preteens. We missed him a lot. It was hard. We did, we Skyped, we wrote letters, postcards, photos, you name it. We pretty much did it just to stay connected as a family.
Deployment for me was twofold. First, I missed my family. It's very difficult to be away from your family for a year. It's just not normal to be away from your family that long. And to be in a third world country where you really don't know anybody, especially at the holidays, it was very difficult. I missed my family very much. But on the other side, it was very awesome to be able to help do humanitarian missions, help the local populace with their livestock, and give them medical treatment that was much needed to help keep them alive.
Dad's deployment for me was hard. Because me and the boys, we always grew up with, every now and then he'd be gone to the field for a week or two at most, and then he'd be back and he was never that far off, so if he actually needed to be home, he could get home. But I think what made it hard was he was so far away, and I was just so used to always having him at home and always being able to talk to him and see him, and then it changed and it made things hard.
The hardest part about being a spouse to someone that is in the military is the constant worry. You're always watching them leave. I always heard that it takes a special kind of someone to be a spouse to a person in the military.
Growing up in the Army and just being around the military in general was different. It wasn't like, most people's childhood or how they grew up. We moved around a lot. We went to a lot of different schools. We met a lot of different people and experienced a lot of things that not many people got to.
In the Army, I did receive some awards. I received 5 Meritorious Service Medals. I received 2 Army Commendation Medals, an Army Achievement Medal, and a Joint Service Achievement Medal.
My first thought when John said he was going to retire was that I was relieved, but yet worried at the same time, because the military is the only life that we've ever known. You've done it for so long and you become accustomed to certain things and being around certain things and hearing things, and it's like it all just gets taken away.
My initial thought when Dad told me he was retiring, and then when it actually happened, when he actually retired, it was weird because, I always woke up or went about my day knowing that he was on post or he was at the academy or he was at the hospital that he happened to be working at, that where we were stationed. So, thinking now that every time I see him, he's not in uniform, he's not a part of the Army anymore. It's kind of weird, but I know he's happy to finally be retired after giving 21 years.
The reason I retired was I could no longer physically keep up with the demands of my job or with the younger soldiers. And And always said when I couldn't keep up with the 20-year-old soldiers, I would retire. So for me, it was primarily a physical reason.
What I do now, since he's retired, and I do a lot of crafting. I have a whole entire craft room to myself. I have, you name it, I got it. I got yarn, fabric, paint. My husband has, and my kids have bought me stuff throughout the years that I've just kept, and people have given me stuff, and I've made curtains, I've made costumes for the boys when they were little, I can take something old and turn it into something new, so I think that's what I love about crafting. It's just, the sky's the limit, and I can do what I want.
Since I've retired and I've been ingrained in retirement, I feel like we've come twofold. We've moved back to Southern Illinois where we started from. I'm back to working as a nurse. I'm near family where we can see our loved ones whenever we want, have Sunday dinners. I've picked up some woodworking skills. I love building tables, chairs, just doing small projects for my wife in her craft room. I enjoy fishing. I'm looking forward to getting to do a lot of hunting. I'm just enjoying having time for myself now. Now that I only work 8 hours a day, I have time to enjoy just being alive.
A lot of things were that me and my dad are able to do together now that, you know, he's retired and he has, you know, more time to spend with family. He's been the one that's helped me and pushed me to get in better shape to enlist with the Navy, which few days ago I finally did. So him being able to work out with me and push me and motivate me, that's definitely one of the things that we're able to do and together and frequently now that he's retired.
One thing I would probably tell somebody if they were considering joining the military is prepare yourself, prepare your family so that they know the if there's information out there about the military for you to learn, learn it, because it will only help you later.